Nah, I'm just kidding. Just realize you've only got a couple of weeks left, so make sure you're still working hard. And if there's stuff you've missed out on from earlier in the lockdown period, fortunately, it's all on YouTube, so just go back and do it, and then email me with the work. Happy days. So let's go back on social distancing. Explain 2 meters for geographers to rivers, the high force waterfall on the River Tees. 2 meters is approximately 1/10 the drop of high force waterfall on the River Tees. Link to the Do Now quiz is on ePraise or in the description. Pause here and get it done. Answers already on there. So a bit of feedback on the Do Now quiz, because it's predominantly been diagram work for the last few weeks, other than the exam question, which I've already fed back on from a few lessons back. We're looking at this question. New land created by deposited material which links two headlands is known as. Now the answer is a bar, but what we need to be really careful of is lots of people putting spit. Lots of people put in Tombolo, lots of people put in Lagoon. The problem here, I think, is that we are not reading the question closely enough. And it's that bit which I've put a circle around, which links two headlands. That's the bit that gives us the clue that this is a bar rather than a spit, a Tombolo. Lagoon is a little bit of a confusing element to it, because obviously the area of water is then called the lagoon. But the new land created by that deposited material is a bar, as the diagram shows at the bottom. So be careful. Normally I'd expect, well, I'd hope for 100% of students getting the question right. I can kind of live with 80% for now, but 36, no, more of us should have been getting that right. So moving on to today. Today we're going to look at coastal management. We've looked at general principles of coastal management last couple of lessons, talking about hard engineering and soft engineering. Today we're going to look at a specific case study, and we're going to look at Swanage Bay, somewhere which hopefully we will visit for field work, although obviously we're living in unprecedented times and there's no guarantee. But you'll have a pretty good understanding of Swanage Bay, what it's like, and how coastal management is used there from what we're going to look at today. A quick recap. Coastal management incorporates two different strategies: hard engineering strategies, soft engineering strategies. Hard engineering involve man-made structures which are built to prevent coastal flooding and maintain existing coastlines. Soft engineering is management that tries to work with natural processes to reduce flood risk and maintain coastlines. So why does Swanage Bay need protecting? There's a fantastic aerial photograph there of Swanage Bay, looking from south to north towards Ballard's Point and Old Harry in the far distance. We can see Swanage Bay on the west of that image. Swanage Bay has a beach, and that beach attracts tens of thousands of tourists every single year. Consequently, Swanage Bay has an extremely valuable local economy. Swanage Bay makes lots and lots of money through tourism, so therefore economically is a significant location. Swanage itself is a town with over 10,000 residents, and obviously everywhere there, every one of those properties, all of these places where they live, are all valuable residences as well. So the beach and the tourist industry, which contribute huge amounts to the economy, plus the fact that it's a town with over 10,000 people living there, are all reasons why Swanage Bay needs protecting. the risks that exist. So Swan's Bay are predominantly based around longshore drift. The movement of material from the south of the bay to the north of the bay and away from the bay by waves which are refracted around the coastline to the south. Longshore drift reduces the size of the beach. That makes the beach less attractive to tourists, which would reduce visitor numbers. This would cause the local economy to decline, and the top three boxes on that flow diagram explain that. Longshore drift reduces the size of the beach, less protection for cliffs, resulting in slides and slumps, what we call mass movement. Therefore, there's then a risk to local life and to coastal property caused by the sliding and the slumping, particularly during storms when the waves will be attacking the base of the cliff, the saturated rock is more likely to slide and to slump, and there's a serious risk to life and property. So clearly, Swanage Bay needs protecting. And Swanage Bay has needed protecting for a long time. The first solutions to the various different coastal processes affecting Swanage Bay were put in place well over 100 years ago. And there were a range of solutions which were put in place prior to 1960, from the 1800s through to 1960. These were groynes, because longshore drift was removing the beach. If you trap the beach, trap the sediment, then that means that the beach will absorb wave energy and reduce erosion. So groynes have been in place for over 100 years, and a seawall to reflect wave energy and to protect the town when waves did get all the way up the beach. So prior to 1960, there was a seawall and there were very effective groynes. In the 1980s, it was a review was held and it was decided that actually the current defences needed improvements. So the seawall wasn't as effective as it should have been, and the groynes were becoming less effective over time. Consequently, significant amounts of rock armour was put in place, and if you're to look at an image of Swanage Bay, you will see the groynes, you will see the seawall, but you'll also see the seawall has rock armour in front of it. This absorbs wave energy and helped Swanage Bay to maintain its seawall for longer. They also needed cliff drainage, and that reduced saturation of the cliffs and it reduced those chances of mass movement such as slumping or sliding. All of this was done in the 80s as a secondary attempt to manage the coast and to prevent coastal flooding and coastal erosion. So now we look at the most recent solutions from the 1990s to the present day. There are 18 new and rebuilt groynes. New, which were never there before, and rebuilt because groynes from the Victorian era will break down and need replacing over time. So there are 18 new and rebuilt groynes stretching the entire length of the bay. Beach nourishment took place. 90,000 cubic meters of material was pumped onto the beach. And we talk about soft engineering and talk about it working with natural processes. You can see from this image, beach nourishment at that scale does result in significant disruption and a significant change to the local environment. So here we can see large-scale beach nourishment. Beach nourishment was 90,000 cubic meters first of all, but then every 20 years, Swanage Bay requires an additional 40,000 cubic meters of material. So this process isn't a one-off process, this process needs to be repeated. And then finally, cliff repair work has taken place in at-risk areas. This is at the base of a hotel, and the hotel actually funded this cliff repair work, and the cliff has been pinned in place so that it's less likely to slump and to slide, and sea defences have been put in at the base to prevent waves eroding the base, and drainage has been run through the cliff to prevent the cliff becoming saturated, because that would then make mass movement more likely. All of these things are designed to protect the hotel building at the top, which is an extremely valuable use along the coastline. The total cost of all of this coastal management is £2.2 million, with an additional 40,000 cubic metres of beach nourishment needed every 20 years. This is a significant amount of money. However, what we need to remember is that the value of tourism to Swanage, something that we will look at in greater detail when we look at fieldwork, is far beyond that. So by maintaining the beach, by maintaining the tourist industry, the town of Swanage has an extremely strong economy. If the beach was to be lost and the tourists were to be lost, then that would result in significant damage to the tourist industry. So everybody's happy? Well, no. This coastal management is effective. The beach is maintained. It protects tourist numbers. It protects recreational uses. If you want to walk your dog along the beach, if you want to go running along the beach, if you just want to visit the beach, even as a local, the beach is maintained and protected. The cost of repairs due to flooding and storms is reduced because the coastline is protected by the old sea wall, by the groins, by the beach. So therefore, flood damage and storm damage at the coast is lessened. However, it's also ineffective because tourists cause congestion and overcrowding, tourists upset local people, the groins look unnatural. So if you want to visit Swanage Bay, or if you live in Swanage Bay and you want to look along a completely natural coastal landscape, that's not what you're seeing. And groins in Swanage stop longshore drift, but obviously that prevents sediment being transported to other nearby coastlines. There are significant beach nourishment programs taking place in Swanage, in Bournemouth, in Poole, all along this coastline, because groins are stopping the natural process of moving material along the coast. And to finish, exciting times, an exam question. Using an example, explain how coastal management can have both economic and social benefits. So a relatively straightforward question, which I think we can answer well. First off, using an example. Well, it's Swanage, isn't it? We've just spoken about Swanage for the last few minutes. Clearly, Swanage is the example that we want to use. Explain coastal management. We need to give specific examples of coastal management and how it can have economic and social benefits. We are only focusing on benefits. Now, as a 6-marker, we want 2 paragraphs. It's nice and easy, isn't it? One of those paragraphs is going to explain economic benefits with chains of reasoning to make it really clear. One of the paragraphs is going to explain social benefits with chains of reasoning to make it really clear. And then a short one sentence conclusion is perfectly adequate to ensure that you're getting full marks if you've done enough within the paragraphs. Pause the video here. If you need to go back through that content and rewatch, that's absolutely fine. If not, pause here, copy that question down into your book, have a go at that question on paper, do it as a 6-minute timed question, and I'm happy for you to do this on paper because I think this is one we can have a really good go at. When you're done, take a photo of it, email that to me so that I can have a look and give you some feedback tomorrow, hopefully, as long as I've got time. So pause here, 6 minutes, have a go. And finally, hopefully your model answer looks something like this. Coastal management can have major economic benefits as seen in Swanage. 18 groins have been built or repaired, 90,000 cubic metres of beach nourishment has been used to protect the beach. As a result of this coastal management, more tourists will be attracted to the area. Due to this, local businesses such as shops, restaurants and accommodation will make more money, employ more people and consequently leading to economic success in Swanage. In addition, coastal management in Swanage has had social benefits. The protected beaches and cliff repair work in at-risk areas have reduced the risk of mass movement. As a result of that, it is now less likely that people's homes and businesses will be damaged or destroyed by coastal retreat. Therefore, people can feel more secure that their home is safe, and due to this, their overall quality of life will improve. Overall, coastal management in Swanage has had significant benefits, both economically and socially. So that's the model answer. Look back over yours, tick what you've done well, add in green the things that you would need to do better based on this broad structure. It doesn't have to be exactly this, you may well have some variation there, but let's just pick out some of the key principles that make this a really strong model answer. First off, we name the example straight away. Swanage. We state that we're going to talk about major economic benefits in the first sentence, so that's our application. Then specific knowledge. 18 coins, 19,000 cubic meters of beach nourishment used to protect the beach. That's a level 3 knowledge. Then we're into a chain of reasoning. As a result of the management, more tourists will be attracted to the area. Due to this, local businesses will be successful, making the economy successful. And that last phrase, consequently leading to economic success in Swanage, nicely rounds it off and make sure that it's very clearly linked to the question. Then, in addition, coastal management in Swanage has had social benefits. Okay, so we're putting together an application sentence that makes it really clear that we're talking about social benefits. Protected beaches and cliff repair work have reduced the risk of mass movement. So that's some nice specific knowledge. Cliff repair work stops mass movement. As a result of this, homes and businesses are protected. People feel more secure. Quality of life improves. That's a clear social benefit. So you're going to get credit there. And then that short, simple conclusion, just to round it off. And that makes a 6 out of 6 answer. So homework questions, knowledge organisers are as an attachment on ePraise. Get them done because this is really good consolidation for the work that you're doing in the online video lessons.